Joseph Diefenthal.
Yes.
State your full name.
Your name? Joseph Diefenthal. Joseph Diefenthal.
How old are you?
The identity.
Vice Charles.
30.
What is your residence?
The Bondes.
Auskirchen by Köln.
Auskirchen. A-U-S-K-I-R-C-H-E-N near Köln. K-O-E-L-N.
Nationality?
Staatsangehörigkeit.
Deutscher.
German.
Were you ever a member of the armed forces of the German Reich?
A member of the Waffen-SS from the 15th of October 1935. Bis wann waren Sie in der Waffen-SS? Up to the 8th of May 1945.
I sign accused number 10.
Number 10.
Sit down. Joseph Sepp Dietrich. State your full name.
Your name? Joseph Dietrich.
How old are you?
The identity. You're working there. 54.
What is your residence?
Le Bondes, Munich.
Nationality?
Staatsangehörigkeit, German.
Were you ever a member of the armed forces of the German Reich?
Yes.
Of what component were you a member and during what period of time?
In welchem Teil waren Sie und während welcher Zeitspanne?
The Waffen-SS.
In the Waffen-SS from February 1933 up to the capitulation.
I sign accused number 11.
Number
8. Pleps. State your full name.
Your name?
George Pleps.
How old are you?
The identity.
23.
What is your residence?
Michaelsberg, M-I-C-H-A-E-L-S-B-E-R-G
in Romania.
Nationality?
Christoph Knittel.
State your full name.
Nennen Sie Ihren vollen Namen.
Christoph Knittel.
How old are you?
31.
Wie alt sind Sie?
31.
Zu welchem Teil haben Sie angehört? Welchen Teil haben Sie angehört und zu welchem Zeitpunkt? In the Waffen-SS from the 2nd of August 34 until the end of the war.
Fritz Kramer.
Fritz Kramer.
State your full name.
Nennen Sie Ihren vollen Namen bitte.
Fritz Ludwig Karl Kramer.
Fritz Ludwig Karl Kramer. K-R-A-E-M-E-R.
How old are you?
Wie alt sind Sie?
45 Jahre.
45 years. From the 1st of May 1933 until the 1st, the 8th month, 44, a member of the Wehr, Paul Hermann Ochmann.
State your full name.
Nennen Sie Ihren vollen Namen.
Paul Hermann Ochmann.
Paul Hermann Ochmann, O-C-H-M-A-N-N.
How old are you?
Wie alt sind Sie? 32 years old.
What is your residence?
Wo's Ihr Wohnsitz? Gut. Louis, L-O-U-I-S-D-O-R-F, in Silesia.
Nationality?
Ihre Staatsangehörigkeit, German.
I sign accused number 41.
Number 41.
Joachim Piper.
Joachim Piper.
State your full name.
Nennen Sie Ihren vollen Namen.
Joachim Piper.
Joachim Piper, P-I-E-P-E-R.
How old are you?
Wie alt sind Sie?
31 Jahre.
31 years old.
What is your residence?
Was ist Ihr Wohnsitz?
Rottach am Tegernsee.
Rottach, A-R-O-T-T-A-C-H, on the Tegernsee.
Nationality.
Ihre Staatsangehörigkeit.
German.
Were you ever a member of the armed forces of the German Reich?
Waren Sie jemals Mitglied der Streitkräfte des Deutschen Reiches? Yes.
Of what component were you a member and during what period of time?
Welchem Teil und zu welchem Zeitpunkt haben Sie angehört?
Angehörige der Waffen-SS von Oktober 1934 bis
Ende. I was a member of the Waffen-SS from October 1934 until the end of the war.
I signed the accused number 42.
Hermann Priest.
Priest, state your full name.
Nennen Sie Ihren Namen.
Hermann August Friedrich Priest.
Hermann August Friedrich Priest. P R I E S S.
How old are you?
Wie alt sind Sie?
44
years.
What is your residence?
Was ist Ihr Wohnsitz?
Were you ever a member of the armed forces of the German Reich?
Waren Sie jemals Mitglied der Streitkräfte des Deutschen Reiches? Yes.
Of what component were you a member and during what period of time?
Welchem Teil haben Sie angehört und zu welchem Zeitpunkt?
Ralph Roland Reiser.
Hier.
State your full name.
Roland Reiser. Nennen Sie Ihren Namen.
Roland Roland Reiser.
Ralph Roland Reiser. R-E-I-S-E-R.
How old are you?
Wie alt sind Sie?
25
years old.
What is your residence?
Was ist Ihr Wohnort?
Hermannstadt, Rumänien.
Hermannstadt. R-E-H-E-R-M-A-N-N-S-T-A-D-T in Romania.
Nationality.
Ihre Staatsangehörigkeit. Romanian.
Were you ever a member of the armed forces of the German Reich?
Waffen-SS from the 15th of July 1942 until the end of the war.
I signed the accused number 49.
Nummer 49.
Wolfgang Richter.
Wolfgang Richter.
State your full name.
Nennen Sie Ihren vollen Namen. J-E-N-A in Thuringia.
Nationality.
Ihre Staatsangehörigkeit. German.
Were you ever a member of the armed forces of the German Reich?
Waren Sie jemals Mitglied der Streitkräfte des Deutschen Reiches? Yes. German.
Were you ever a member of the armed forces of the German Reich?
you stay there?
Wie lange sind Sie dort geblieben?
6 Tage.
6 days.
And isn't it a fact that you were moved prior to the 10th of December and put into a hospital cell?
Und ist es nicht wahr, dass Sie aus dieser Zelle herauskamen vor dem 10. Dezember und in eine Lazarettzelle gebracht wurden? Yes.
And how long did you stay in that hospital cell?
Und wie lange sind Sie in dieser Lazarettzelle geblieben?
Etwa 3 Monate.
For about 3 months.
And then where were you moved to?
Und dann wo sind Sie hingekommen?
Dann bin ich in eine der gewöhnlichen Gefängniszellen gekommen.
When I came in the ordinary cell of the jail.
Were you alone when you were in this ordinary cell?
Nein, als in dieser Gewöhnungszelle waren.
Ja, wieder bekam ich Gewöhnung.
Well, is that your handwriting?
Ist das Ihre Handschrift?
Is that your signature?
Ist das Ihre Unterschrift?
Yes. What date is that signed and where?
Welches Datum steht da und wo?
25.
True.
Nun ist diese Niederschrift wahr.
Kann ich
It's true, if it is damaging, it's untrue, is that correct?
Und wenn der Inhalt Ihnen irgendwelchen Schaden tun kann, dann ist es nicht wahr. Und wenn er Ihnen keinen Schaden tun kann, dann ist es wahr. Ist das richtig?
Ich habe mich noch niemals vor irgendeinem Schaden gefürchtet.
I never was afraid of any damage.
Do you usually read statements before you sign them?
Lesen Sie Niederschriften gewöhnlich durch, bevor Sie sie unterschreiben?
Jawohl.
Yes.
Ah, it's true or not.
Erinnern Sie sich jetzt, ob es wahr oder nicht wahr ist?
Ich muss mir noch mal wiederholen. Ich müsste das vorher durchlesen.
I must repeat it. I should have an opportunity to read it first.
Well, I'll read you, or withdraw that. Yesterday, I think you testified on direct examination.
Gestern, glaube ich, haben Sie im direkten Verhör gesagt.
That Heidecke made some statement about that they would kill prisoners of war because they would be granted no pardon.
Und dass Heidecke
they were captured.
Irgendwelche Aussagen gemacht hat, dass sie Kriegsgefangene machen würden, da man ihnen auch keine Barmherzigkeit zeigen würde, wenn sie gefangen genommen würden.
In substance, I believe that's true, isn't it?
Und im Grunde genommen ist das wahr, nicht wahr? Die Substanz.
Ich glaube, Sie haben was anderes übersetzt, als das, was Herr Oberstleutnant Ellis gesagt hat.
Would you reread this question, please? I guess that was a mistake. The last part of it, please. Ich glaube, im Grunde genommen ist das wahr.
Ich habe gestern ausgesagt.
I stated yesterday.
Hardik machte mir eine Äußerung gegenüber.
Hardik made an expression towards me.
In welche er ausführte.
Wherein he explained to me.
Dass sie kein Pardon geben würden.
That they would not give any pardon.
Da sie ebenfalls erschossen werden würden, wenn sie in Feindes Hand fielen.
Because they would be shot in the same manner if they would happen to fall into enemy's hand.
Und dass sie eingesetzt würden unter den gleichen Verhältnissen wie die britischen Kommandounternehmen.
And that they were put into operation under the same conditions as the British
Kommandounternehmen.
Commando undertakings.
Now I'll read this paragraph from the statement of yours, which is dated 25th April.
Nun lese ich Ihnen diesen Paragraph von Ihrer
Niederschrift. My question of what he would do with prisoners, he answered, we do not give pardon. If we get caught, we will also be bumped off.
Auf meine Frage, was er mit Gefangenen tun würde, antwortete er, wir werden ihnen keine Barmherzigkeit zeigen. Wenn wir gefangen werden, dann werden wir auch erledigt werden.
Is that true?
Jawohl. Ist das wahr? Yes.
I'll read the last paragraph of this statement.
Lest
the 25th of April.
Den letzten Paragraphen dieser Niederschrift vom 25. April.
Hardiki fell on the first day of the offensive. His combat group was not under me, but directly under the Panzer Brigade 13, parenthesis Mission Greif, which to my knowledge again was placed directly under the 1st SS Panzer Corps. The commander of the Mission Greif was Sturmbannführer Skorzeny. Is that paragraph true?
Hardy.
Dieser Paragraph ist wahr. Ich muss allerdings sagen, dass ich keine genaue Aussage machen kann, wem Skorzeny nun direkt unterstand. Ob dem Korps, ob der Armee oder dem Führer direkt.
This paragraph is true. However, I must say that I cannot make a certain statement as to whom Skorzeny, as to under whose command Skorzeny actually was. If under the command of the Corps,
the Army,
of the Army,
or, the Führer direct.
Or of the Führer directly.
We concede that such feelings are natural and admirable traits, but we most vigorously contend that there are principles which transcend them and to which all peoples of all civilized nations owe an even higher allegiance. Among them is the sanctity of agreements between nations and the moral validity of such plain and long accepted covenants as those that were smeared with the blood of our countrymen and of allied nationals by these accused. These victims, too, had a love of country and a devotion to the cause for which they fought. It was certainly not easy for them to lay down their arms and surrender. When they did so, they expected and had a right to expect that they would be treated humanely and protected against acts of violence in accordance with the rules of warfare. To forgive or even mitigate the punishment of those who then took their lives on the ground that they acted out of loyalty to country would be a breach of faith with those who fought fairly and honorably, a quasi-approval or endorsement of the principle that any means, no matter how low or barbaric, justifies the ends, and a shock to the conscience of the civilized peoples of the world. It should not be overlooked that with the exception of two of the victims, all were killed between the 17th and 23rd of December 1944. In this one short week, I am sure that the record of approximately 750 American prisoners of war and 150 Belgian civilians murdered in cold blood would even satisfy the demands of the accused Hendel to exceed in the killing as well as in the fighting. It is a bloody record indeed that the 1st SS Panzer Regiment set for itself in this one short week. Let us hope that it has never been surpassed, nor that never again will such a record even be approached. Today in America, the survivors of these massacres, the mothers, fathers, sweethearts, wives and children of those comrades of ours who so needlessly fell, not on the field of battle, but from the tender mercies of the SS, are awaiting your findings. These comrades all would have been alive today if it had not been for the 1st SS Panzer Regiment, and they must not have died in vain. From their deaths, let there come a clear understanding to our former enemies that they cannot wage war in a merciless and ruthless manner. They must learn that the end does not justify the means, that truth, honor, and mercy cannot be sacrificed for success, and that the honorable soldiers of the world still have mercy on the field of battle for their captured opponents. It must be brought home to the German people that the principle of extermination which guided them in their last battle
will not create for them a new and better world, but will only bring disaster to their homeland and to themselves. Let their punishment be adequate for their crimes. There you got it, boys.
Hohes Gericht, am 22. August 1915 wurde ich in Meran in Sachsen geboren. Mein Vater fiel 1915 im Ersten Weltkrieg. Ich besuchte 8 Jahre die Volksschule und erlernte den Apparateurberuf. Ich hatte eine sehr harte Jugendzeit. 1939 heiratete ich, ich habe 2 Kinder. Ich wurde aus der SS-Partei ausgestoßen und bis zum Kriegsende nicht wieder aufgenommen. Ich wurde zur Strafkompanie des Pionierbataillons 3. SS-Division versetzt. Bei dieser Einheit kämpfte ich im Osten und wurde Ende Oktober 1941 schwer verwundet. Ich nahm an 71 Stoßtrupps teil. Nach Ablauf meiner Strafzeit und Rehabilitierung wurde ich zur 1. SS-Panzerdivision versetzt. Während meiner Einsatztage im 2. Weltkrieg wurde ich 7-mal verwundet, davon 4-mal am Kopf. Während meiner zweijährigen Strafzeit erhielt meine Familie keinerlei finanzielle Unterstützung. Bei der Besetzung von Berlin wurde meine Familie enteignet und musste innerhalb 10 Minuten Haus und Heim verlassen haben. Sie steht völlig mittellos da. Ich appelliere zu diesem Gericht für Gerechtigkeit und Gnade.
May it please the court. This is a plea for mitigation of the defendant, Heinz Hendel. I was born in Moraine, Saxony on the 22nd day of August, 1915. My father died in 1915 in the First World War. I visited for 8 years the elementary school and learned the trade of cloth designer. I had a very hard youth. I married in 1939 and have 2 children. I was thrown out of the SS and the party and not readmitted in the beginning of the war. At the end of the war, I was readmitted. I was transferred to the punishment company of the Engineer Battalion of the 3rd SS Armored Division. With this unit, I fought in the East, and at the end of October 1941, I was seriously wounded. I participated in 71 assaults. Upon the completion of my punishment time and after my rehabilitation, I was transferred to the 1st SS Armored Division. During my commitment in the Second World War, I was wounded 7 times, 4 times on the head. During the 2 years of my punishment, my family did not receive any financial support. During the occupation of Berlin, my family's property was confiscated, and they were forced to leave their home within 10 minutes after the occupation. They are now without means of support. I appeal to this court for justice and mercy.
May it please the court, various accused have presented to you their personal pleas in mitigation for your consideration while deliberating on the sentence in their individual cases. Some have made no plea, due in a few cases to a complete reliance on the inadequate evidence as presented against them, while others have felt that you, as officers of the United States Army, will judge them fairly without any further plea. At this time, however, the accused have requested that a common plea be entered on their behalf. At this time, however, the accused have requested that a common plea be entered on behalf of any whom you might draw the death penalty. Let it be remembered that these 73 accused are soldiers It is respectfully requested that those few who may be adjudged the death penalty, that they be accorded a firing squad, which we feel are the rights and privileges of a soldier. General Meyer, commanding general of the division, Hitler Youth was sentenced to death by shooting in a similar case by a Canadian court. It is not believed that this simple soldier's request should be denied by you.
Court in closed session. At least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring sentences you to death by hanging. The court in closed session. At least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring sentences you to death by hanging. At such time and place as higher authority may direct. Joseph Dietrich. The court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to life imprisonment, commencing forthwith at such places may be designated by competent military authority.
Joseph Dietrich, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zu lebenslänglicher Freiheitsstrafe, deren Vollstreckung sofort beginnt. Die Strafe wird einfach der höheren Militärbehörde bestimmten Ort vollstreckt werden.
Fritz Eichmann. Court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present, at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to death by hanging, at such time and place as higher authority may direct.
Jörg Flöps, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zum Tode durch der Hängen. Vollstreckung des Urteils wird von höheren Militärbehörden bestimmt werden.
Closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present, at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to death by hanging, at such time and place as our authority may direct.
Willy Heinz Händel, nach Beratung und unter Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zum Tode durch Erhängen.
The court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to death by hanging, at such time and place as our authority may direct.
Joachim Hoffmann, nach Beratung und unter Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zum Tode durch Erhängen. Zeit und Ort der Vollstreckung werden von der höheren Militärbehörde bestimmt.
The court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to death by hanging at such time and place as high authority may direct.
Friedel Kies, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zum Tode durch Verhängen. Zeit und Ort der Vollstreckung der Todesstrafe werden von der höheren Militärbehörde bestimmt werden.
Gustav Knittel. closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to life imprisonment, commencing forthwith at such places may be designated by competent military authority.
Knüppel, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilt sie das Gericht zu lebenslänglicher Freiheitsstrafe, ein Vollstreckung sofort begehen.
George Kutzer. Court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring. Sentences you to be imprisoned for a term of 10 years, commencing forthwith at such places may be designated by competent military authority.
Mit Kramer, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zu einer Freiheitsstrafe von 10 Jahren. Vollstreckung beginnt sofort, die Strafe wird dann von der höheren Militärbehörde bestimmt, sofort vollstreckt werden.
Werner Kuhn.
Vollstreckung werden von der höheren Militärbehörde bestimmt werden.
Gustav Neve. Pfeiffer. The court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to death by hanging at such time and place as our authority may direct.
Joachim Pfeiffer, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zum Tode durch Verhängen. Zeit und Ort der Vollstreckung der Todesstrafe werden von höheren Militärbehörden bestimmt werden.
Court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to be imprisoned for a term of 20 years, commencing forthwith at such places may be designated by competent military authority.
Hermann Fries, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zu einer Freiheitsstrafe von 20 Jahren. Die Strafe wird von der höheren Militärbehörde sofort vollstreckt werden.
Court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to death by hanging at such time and place as our authority may direct.
Court second, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zum Tode durch Verhängen. Zeit und Ort der Vollstreckung der Todesstrafe von der höheren Militärbehörde bestimmt werden.
Oswald Siegler.
Zwei Drittel bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder verurteilte das Gericht zu lebenslänglicher Freiheitsstrafe. Der Vollstreckung sofort beginnt.
The court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to life imprisonment, commencing forthwith at such places may be designated by competent military authority.
Erwin Schipersky, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zu lebenslänglicher Freiheitsstrafe, deren Vollstreckung sofort beginnt. Strafe wird von der Militärbehörde bestimmt, sofort vollstreckt.
Edmund Thompson. The court in closed session, at least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring, sentences you to death by hanging at such time and place as our authority may direct.
Hans Turmhout, nach Beratung und Zustimmung von mindestens zwei Drittel der bei der Abstimmung anwesenden Mitglieder, verurteilte das Gericht zum Tode durch Verhängen. Zeit und Ort der Vollstreckung der Todesstrafe werden von der höheren Militärbehörde bestimmt werden.
Eric Winner. At such places may be designated by competent military authority.
Dr. Wismar.
The court report in closed session. At least two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken concurring sentences you to death by hanging at such time and place as our authority may direct. Okay.